We are watching the situation. At the moment, it's not established. It's a hit. Our bookings are going on well. But we realize that if the rupee stays at this level for a long time, then we expect our summer 2014, we have to be careful in planning what products we have to bring to the market. No, we expect some of our customers to look at maybe a reduced Europe trip or to shift their trip to a Dubai or a Far East tour or even a domestic tour. As a company, all I can say is that we are equipped to be able to handle the changing customer preferences as best as we can. That's because travel companies have worked hard over the years to reduce the cost of the package, and right now maybe the depreciation is making it look costly. But most of the packages that are on offer on a real term basis are much cheaper than they were 5 years ago, one. And second is, I think the affluence of Indians, especially middle class, has reached a level where, frankly, it doesn't matter to a large section of the community whether the rupee is trading at 60 or 65. I think we make a lot of noise about it in the media. And actually, those people on the fringe are just changing itineraries to suit their pocket. So as a travel company, so long as I'm not losing customers and customers are traveling, we expect to be doing good business. On affordability, because we are Kony and Kony globally, we've been able to source some of the prices from our destination management companies, also owned by Kony, at decent rates. Okay, and we believe that that is important for us. However, to be fair, there are always going to be travel agents who can be able to beat the price that we offer, because we imbue the product with a certain product quality, and which we would never want to compromise. So would you get a cheaper product to any destination that I offer? Yes, of course. Would you get the same quality? Is what I'd like the customer to make this, See, we are in business travel, okay, where we handle the travel business of all corporates, and we become their travel policy managers. We get rewarded by virtue of a transaction fee. What the online companies face in terms of diminished margins from airlines, I'm not saying we don't face at all, but I'm saying we face to a lesser degree, because we are aligned to the customer, and our earnings come not from the commission, but maybe because of some volume commitments that we have achieved through PLBs, etc. Okay, so this fact that commissions are coming down has been a known fact. A lot of markets worldwide have come to zero commission. So it's time that travel agents in particular need to adjust to this changing reality.